let's start kind of at the beginning. Where is Arkansas right now? And you're like many other states. You've got a lot of challenges and a tough time to work on issues. Nobody seems to want to work together. We can't seem to figure out that our young people are our future. We say that, but we sort of never really believe it. Well, who's going to be your nurse and doctor when you're 75 and 80? Who's going to invent your next invention? Who's going to do whatever? It's our young people. You have about 500,000 young people in your public schools in Arkansas. Almost 300,000 of them are low-income students, and we know that they're going to have more challenges to get ahead, and that's why after-school and summer opportunities in partnership with the community, seniors and colleges and community folks are so critical, and they're out of school 75 to 80% of the time. We've got to figure out how to use that time better. And we're learning more and more that the only kind of best path to middle income and self-sufficiency, everybody's upset about welfare, and we should be. We don't want folks on welfare, but if you don't have education, you can't make it in the future. And that's just the way it is. And for a lot of working families who don't have a place for their kids to go or after school, home alone is not a funny movie. In Arkansas, you have one of the highest rates of working families in America. 70% of families, whoever the parent is, one or two, are both working. And we'll find out later that about 150,000 or more kids go home alone after school every day in Arkansas. That's inviting lots of trouble. Now, some positive news, sort of. There's some projections out that over the next 7 or 8 years, 2020, there's going to be about 150,000 more jobs in Arkansas. And it's hard to believe with this recession we've been through. But you can see it coming back. It's going to keep continuing. But here's the challenge. Most of those jobs will require some post-high school career or 2 or 4 year college. And for young people who drop out, there actually is no good avenue to get a good job in the future. And we can only handle about in Arkansas 10% of a class without a high school diploma. I think your dropout rate is around 25-30%. What are those students going to do? They can't make it. There is not going to be jobs for them. They're going to be a drain on society. We have to find a way to give them a leg up. Milton Chan is a executive director of the George Lucas Foundation, a really unique guy. He argues that one of the bright spots in American education, in addition to all the great stuff you're doing in your classrooms and school, is this third space of learning between 3 and 6 and in the summers. Think about it. The families play a critical role in America, and always have and always will, in laying the foundation. Schools, public schools play a critical role. But what's the third space between 3 and 6 in the summers? What can we do in that third space? And what we're seeing is some really exciting things going on. Exciting partnership among educators and community groups. And his final comment, he's done a lot of work with countries around the world. He says, don't tell people in Singapore, Finland, or Shanghai about this interesting school-community partnership to fill the third space, because they'll actually do it if they figure it out. Now, isn't that a shame? We can't tell them the great idea we're doing to another country because they may do it, and we seem to be stuck and not doing it. We should do something about that. Educators increasingly are getting interested in this space of after school and summer because of its flexibility and ability to build partnerships. And a educator that we know that's in the room wrote me to say something to the effect, these opportunities after school and summer in partnership offer a pathway to the future at a time when there may be too much outside emphasis on technocratic teaching that is disempowering and uninspiring. Let's be honest. The after-school space allows some respite from the ongoing obsession with finite ways of knowing in our continuing, sometimes steady strive to increase multiple choice tests. Do some of you in education feel that way? Yeah, I got a lot of nods. That's a shame. We got to keep working through it. But this third space is a good place to work on this.